What's up, everybody? Laszlo here, and welcome to my first reaction video. Since I've been on YouTube for a few years, and this is kind of my comeback tour that I'm going through right here, I figured my first reaction tour, what would be better to react to than Time Magazine's list of the top 50 original YouTube videos? All right, so this very first one, I'm not too sure I've ever actually seen it. It's called, I think this is the right one. It's called Trapped in an Elevator. It's 10 years old. So it's from 2008, so it's definitely got to be kind of a YouTube original. This is number 50, I believe, on the Time Magazine list. So, let's check it out. Friday, October 15th, 1999, 11 p.m. McGraw-Hill Building, New York City. Nicholas White takes a cigarette break. White heads back upstairs in car number 30. Oh, the fact that it starts off with an hour counter cannot be a good sign for how this guy's day is gonna go. So first, you start hitting the little button, start getting a little fidgety. Oh, and he's trapped between floors, actually on the concrete, yeah. Oh, 1 hour. Oh, that looks miserable. It's like a nightmare. 4 hours. Is anybody even... It's not really quite clear whether anybody's actually coming to help him at this point. Has he gotten a hold of somebody? I would hope at some point he got a hold of somebody. So I hope the guy on the ladder is coming to help him 13 hours later, or is that dude just doing standard maintenance while this dude's sitting trapped in the basement? That guy's... No. He's not there to help him. He's not. So 23 hours. This is about where the insanity sets in. We'll start digging out with the spoon. Oh my God. He's just curled up in the fetal position. He's just given up on life. How long did this go on for? I can't believe I never heard about this. Hey! Oh, the anticlimactic sign in the elevator. 41 hours. 41 hours trapped in an elevator. I would lose my mind. That dude must have been just a stirbox of insanity by the time he escaped that. That is insane. So that's number 50. Now on to number 49. Unfortunately, this one I actually do know, and I do vaguely remember. And as much as I blocked it out, I'm afraid it's going to be just as painful the second time as it was the first. This is Charlie the Unicorn. If you haven't witnessed it before, then you're in for a treat.
Hey, Charlie! Hey, Charlie, wake up! Yeah, Charlie, you silly sleepyhead, wake up!
Oh God, you guys. This had better be pretty freaking important. Is the meadow on fire?
No, Charlie. We found a map to Candy Mountain. Candy Mountain, Charlie. Yeah, Charlie. We're going to Candy Mountain. Come with us, Charlie. Yeah, Charlie. It'll be an adventure. We're going on an adventure, Charlie.
Yeah, Candy Mountain, right. I'm just gonna, you know, go back to sleep now.
No, Charlie! You have to come with us to Candy Mountain! Yeah, Charlie! Candy Mountain! It's a land of sweets and joy!
Oh, God, it's like a bad version of South Park on steroids. It just keeps going.
Charlie! Oh!
There's more.
God, what is that?
It's a Leopleurodon, Charlie. A magical Leopleurodon. It's gonna guide our way to Candy Mountain.
All right, guys, you do know that there's no actual Candy Mountain, right?
Shun the non-believer. Shun. Shun.
Yeah. Well, what do you know? There actually is a Candy Mountain.
Candy Mountain! Candy Mountain!
Thanks, but no thanks. I'm gonna stay out here.
But you have to enter the Candy Mountain Candy Cave, Charlie!
No, you don't, Charlie. Don't do it, Charlie! Don't do it!
Oh, when you're down and looking for some cheering up, then just head right on up to the Candy Mountain Cave. When you get inside, you'll find yourself a cheery land, such a happy and joy-filled and perky merry land. They've got lollipops and gummy drops and candy things, oh, so many things that will brighten up your day. It's impossible to wear a frown in Candy Town. It's the mecca of love, the Candy Cave.
It still hurts. It still hurts just as bad today as it did back then. I feel a little dumber today than I did yesterday. Alright, well that's Charlie the Unicorn. Oh, it can only go up from here, right? Right? Ah. Alright, so that's first two down. On to the third. This one is another one that I somehow missed. It's called Christian the Lion. So, we'll see how this one goes. This one's new. I haven't heard... I somehow missed this one as well, so... Alright, gotta enjoy seeing new stuff, right? Woohoo! As long as it's not a... bad as the last one. In 1969, John Rendell and Ace Berg saw a lion cub for sale in Harrods. Cramped and lonely and a smile something, I missed that anyways, get the idea. The local vicar allowed them to exercise the cub, now named Christian, in the church grounds. But he very quickly became too big for their flat. The only thing they could do was to try and reintroduce him to Africa, which they managed to do a year later. They wanted to visit him! Ow! Something. I read that so wrong. He's now the head of his own pride! Oh, you go, Christian! He was completely wild and would remember them. After many hours of looking for the pride, this is what happened when they finally found the wild lion. I don't. Okay. So cute. Aww. I'm so on edge right now. Why are you hugging a lion? It's adorable, but it's fucking terrifying. Alright, now there's a shirtless man. Alright, this is starting to get a little oddly sensual. Oh, they introduced him to his wife. Okay. Why? What's with the shirtless dude? Love knows no limits, and true friendships last a lifetime. All right, so I'm realizing I may spend way too much time on Reddit's What Could Go Wrong thread, because I spent that entire time. Hence, I was so waiting for that to go wrong. Like, it was the perfect buildup. Oh, they haven't seen him in years, and he became wild and ahead of his pride, and here he comes running in, and it's gonna be a sensual review. Ah! Oh, God, he's eating me! Maybe I'm just a dark soul, and just not optimistic. What was up with the shirtless guy? That was a little awkward. Well, there you go. That was sweet. Sweet is good. Enjoy the sweet. The sweet. All right, moving on. In at number 46 on the countdown of Time's top 50 YouTube videos of all time is Tillman the Skateboarding Bulldog. Now, I think I may have seen this one before. I don't know if there's really much here that's new. I mean, it's kind of seen a lot of these videos after this one went viral, I think. I think you saw a lot of dogs getting just thrown on every type of locomotive option available and just pushing them down a hill and like, it's adorable until you realize that they don't have brakes. So anyways, here's Tillman the Skateboarding Bulldog. Let's take a look. There he is. Oh man. Woo. Look at him go. Now, I've seen people just throw the dogs on the skateboards, but I've never seen him like given like a push start. Like, he's going after that. Oh, yeah. It's like a kickflip. Go, Tillman. Man, I could only hope to be like a quarter as cool as that dog. I'm such a loser in comparison. Like, when I was a kid, I couldn't even get the skateboard to go straight. Like, I would just set it on flat ground, give it a push, and I'd go 90 degrees to the left and fall on my ass. And this dog's like out there doing tricks. Alright, I take back everything I said before.
It was a kishkaboot, and then,
Alright, I take, yep, this is awesome. It wasn't the most graceful stop I've ever seen there. That was a little laggy. There we go. Hey, that's how you learn, right? You fall down, but you gotta get back up. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Now we're gonna go surfing too? Oh, Tillman. Look at the balls on that dog. Literally. You can see the balls. Anywho. He gets a good little run and start. I like how he tries to give it the little push start. He's so used to being on the skateboard. It doesn't work in water, Tillman. Snow, try and kickstart in the ocean. Oh, now they've got the life vest on him. Oh, he's gonna ride. Catch that wave. Catch it, son. Yes, ride it home, Tillman, my boy. All right, there you have it. Tillman the skateboarding and surfing dog. Wow, multi-talented. Which means he's already better than me in about every aspect of life. So Tillman wins. Although, you know, if you really want to be dark about it, that video is about, what, 10 years old? How long do bulldogs live? Oh, Tillman! No! Well, rest in peace, little buddy. You're a better man than me. Rock on. Rock on, Tillman. Rock on. Riding the waves in heaven. Number 45 as the countdown continues in Casey Kasem's top 50 YouTube videos. Sounded absolutely nothing like Casey Kasem. Is it Casey Kasem? That dude who was on the radio for years? That guy. His top 50 YouTube videos. It's not even his. What am I talking about? Coming in at number 45, Guinness World Record for the most t-shirts worn at once. So, yeah. I mean, that kind of sums it up in the title, but, you know. One guy. Here we go. One guy. This guy. Lots of t-shirts by lots of kids and one world record attempt. Here we go. I like how every shirt has like a drawing from a kid on it. That's so cool. How many kids did they have to kidnap to make this video? It's all just one kid doing it all by himself, and he's just got, like, the world's worst carpal tunnel. He just wears, his wrist braces on and is in a corner crying while they're filming this. Now, Timmy, we need another t-shirt. Get back to work. My dude, if we do the math, he's doing about one shirt per second here with the edits. And this was like a 2.5 minute video. So they're definitely going up in size. Like, they gotta be up to like triple XL at this point, because there's no way you're squeezing a schmedium. You're not squeezing a schmedium over that heft. Go Gunners! I saw it, Arsenal. I like it. I like that kid, whoever that kid is. Cool kid, who's no longer a kid, because this was 12 years ago. He's probably older than me at this point. Nice. 224 shirts. Yeah, that'd be the best. You have any idea how much sweat? Oh, he's got to be miserable. I mean, that's got to be like one of the... Oh, that coming off part has to be like the biggest sensation of relief mixed with misery. Like, just, you're just a husk of sweaty self, just dying to get loose. Oh, but, you know, more power to him, I guess. Those world records are something else. I'll let you guys keep knocking those at him. I'm good just being boring and... Yeah. All right, so that is the first top five. That's 50 through 45 of YouTube's top 50 videos of all time, according to Time Magazine. So that's where we're going to end it here for now. But, you know, I might come back and finish this series, and we'll kind of work our way through the 50 videos. We'll see. But anyways, that was fun. That was kind of interesting. I actually got to see some videos that I hadn't seen before. Hopefully you got to see a couple that you haven't seen before. And, you know, learned a little bit about yourself. If you enjoyed the video, please remember to like, share, subscribe, and ring the ding-a-ling-a-ding-dong bell or whatever. And until next time, I will see you in the next video. Adios.